Hey everyone, this is Kunal from Digit, and this is the Xperia C3 from Sony. This is a quick look at the specifications. So this is a 5.5 inch 720p display. It runs on a Snapdragon 400 1.2 gigahertz quad core processor. There's a 1 GB of RAM and 8 GB of internal memory, although you can only use about 4.3 GB of it. And also, you can expand the memory further with a microSD card. You get NFC, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 3G, and it is a dual SIM device. So yes, you can put two SIMs on it as well. There is an 8 MP camera at the back, an LED flash, a front selfie-centric camera, 5 MP with a soft flash. You know, rest of the stuff is pretty standard on the device. It comes with the Android 4.4.2. Let me just quickly show you that. As you can see, it's 4.4.2 KitKat, and it's not the latest version which Sony has released, which is 4.4.4, but it is you know, KitKat, so you get all the new goodies. The only issue that we've seen is the lock screen is the older one which we had seen on Gingerbread. So it's a swipe up or down to unlock, not your new unlock screen, which is, you know, you can swipe anywhere. Anyway, so the performance on the device is not so bad. You know, we've played a few games, we've run some, you know, benchmarks. Pretty standard for a 22,000 rupee phone. It is pretty large, so you do hamper a bit of the performance because of the large screen. There is a large 2500 mAh battery, which is good to see, and it gives a very nice battery backup. We charged the phone like 200% in overnight, and you know, we got about 1 to 1.5 days of backup, you know, after using the full games, you know, using the camera, you know, social media, you know, constantly using the device. We got about 1.5 to 2 days of, you know, battery backup, which is a lot for a smartphone. So yeah, the video quality comes out pretty good, as the display offers a nice resolution of 720p. The pixel density, like we've said in the earlier video, is a little low because of the 5.5 inch display, but you know, overall I think it's very sharp and very crisp. You know, viewing angles are also pretty decent, and you know, we didn't have any issues under the sunlight, although you need to turn the brightness to full to, you know, see under the sunlight, but overall I think the display works fine. So yeah, the gaming performance is pretty decent. We haven't seen you know, any much of lags or, you know, stuttering on the device. So the Snapdragon 400 processor with the 305 Adreno GPU, it's pretty snappy. It keeps everything in place. The gaming is, you know, pretty much good. Not like, I can't say if it's like 100% of the potential, but to be honest, the gaming experience is perfectly fine. We haven't seen any problems with crashing or, you know, or anything, but I think the Snapdragon 400 processor manages to, you know, deal with all the graphics processing, and you know, if you're playing full HD videos, it manages to, you know, run pretty smoothly. There's also a nice one hand operation because the device is huge. You double tap the home screen, you get the notification bar at the bottom, and you can also change your toggles like so. So you can change that in the settings, you know, and enable one hand operations. Of course, you can't easily use the device with one hand, you have to use two hands, but I think it fits quite well. I mean, it's slim, you know, it feels a little compact thanks to the design, but although it has a very large screen. You get your standard Sony you know, Xperia UI on it, where you can change some themes that you have, or you can download them as well. Plus, the UI has some customized icons, which Sony usually has. Also, the menu drawer has another section where you can arrange it by order, or you can uninstall it, or, you know, whatever. So, very, very Sony-looking device, or everything that you get on a standard Sony smartphone. You also get your Sony apps like Album, Movies, Walkman, plus a bunch of other apps like Social Life, Sketch, Smart Connect, and all that. So this is definitely, you know, Sony is providing all the apps that they put. And let me just talk you through the camera now. So you get the standard camera application. So So you get your standard camera application, which you've seen on Sony Xperia devices, which has a bunch of these modes, which can be downloaded as a separate app as well. So there's something new called portrait retouch, where you can actually take a picture, and it has some modes where you can fine tune it. You can also, so if you're taking from the back camera, it automatically, reads you in the center of the frame and then takes a picture. And other than that, it's very, very, all of the Sony Xperia devices we've seen, this time burst shift, and this superior audio mode, there's AR effect, there's panorama, there's also a manual mode where you can actually, set some of these settings, like brightness and the white balance. So the camera quality is actually quite good. We've tested it out. You can also check out some of these camera samples in the review that we have posted. So probably one of the very good 8-megapixel cameras on this device. Low light is actually good, and with the flash it turns out to be even better. Plus the front camera, it takes some good looking selfies if you are a selfie fan. Do check out, like I said, we've posted some pictures in the review. You can check those out. It is slightly wide, and you can capture, a bunch of your friends if you're taking like a group selfie. So the front camera is pretty decent, and even the rear camera, like I said, has pretty good quality. And you can also take full HD videos with the camera. So that's like a bonus. If you're making videos, if you're on a trip, or if you like going for hiking or anything, you like making videos, so you can shoot videos with this as well. In the benchmarks, it wasn't so surprising. I mean, because it's a big screen, and it's a Snapdragon 400, the results are not very high. But for something which you want like a daily device, if you want to use it for normal stuff like Facebook and Twitter, play a bit of games, taking pictures here and there, I think this will the Snapdragon suffices for that. And overall, the experience on the UI has been very smooth. We didn't see any lag, any stuttering, anything. So it works perfectly fine. The processor gives enough power to, to run the device. So if you're looking for something like a big device, in like a 20,000 range, I think the C3 is a very good looking smartphone. Plus, it performs as well. There have been other devices also with such, form factor, like Sony only had the T2 Ultra, which actually looks like an older version of this device. Plus, there was also the Desire 816, which is, a similar looking smartphone. So, if you're looking for a big phone with a big, large, big real estate on the display, I think the C3 is a very good option.